Hello friends, welcome back to LearnIntegrate tutorials. In this video, I will talk about Kubernetes ingress. End of this session, you will be able to understand what is Kubernetes ingress and how it is different from other Kubernetes services, which means the difference of Kubernetes ingress versus Kubernetes service with architecture. Then I will show you some sample of how to create ingress rules. Then what is Kubernetes ingress controller, and will tell you about the project that supports Kubernetes ingress controller, and finally we'll show you how to set up Kubernetes ingress controller. This is another video from our Kubernetes tutorial series. Related document of this video and other links are mentioned in the description below. Refer those links to understand this session much better from basics. If you still didn't subscribe to our channel, do subscribe now and click nearby bell icon to get the notifications immediately. Let's get started. What is Kubernetes ingress? Kubernetes ingress is also a Kubernetes resource that allows access to your Kubernetes service from outside the Kubernetes cluster, which means that routes traffic using some collection of ingress rules where we defined which inbound connections should reach to which target services. You may have a question now that how the Kubernetes ingress is different from other Kubernetes services, or what is the difference of Kubernetes services versus Kubernetes ingress? Because Kubernetes services also helps us to access our application from outside the cluster, right? Yes, but ingress do a lot more than Kubernetes services. Why? Because it is a single resource that helps us for load balancing, name-based virtual hosting, and SSL terminations, and more. Let's take an example to understand the difference of Kubernetes ingress versus Kubernetes services. This architecture is without ingress controller. Here you have some application being hosted running within your cluster, and if we want to access it from outside the cluster, what would you do? You will create a service to expose the application, either node port or load balancer to expose the application. Here in this diagram, we have used load balancer to show you for each applications. After this is exposed, you must add these into DNS for name resolutions with A record or CNAME record. If you have multiple domains with multiple DNS records for all applications, then you will have multiple entry points to your Kubernetes cluster. For example, if I have these three domains, sales.lanetiquette.net, purchase.lanetiquette.net, and examples.site1.com. These are similar domain with subdomain sales and purchase, and this is a completely the different domain. All these are pointing to my single Kubernetes cluster with multiple entry point. How about if I have a single entry point for all applications that forwards the traffic to the respective services, as like our regular proxy servers in a Kubernetes cluster? So you don't need to expose all your applications to outside the cluster using node port or load balancer service type. Instead, just change all your application service type to cluster IP and keep your application safe within the cluster like private applications. Then just create an ingress controller that will be facing the external network. An ingress controller is nothing but it's also a pod that should be created to route the traffic, and just define the rules in ingress resources. Now you will expose only your ingress controller to outside the cluster using node port or load balancer. Then go to your DNS and modify all the domain names to point our ingress controller. For sales.lanetiquette.net, purchase.lanetiquette.net, examples.site1.com, all are pointing to our Kubernetes ingress controller, which means at this point we will have a single entry point to all our applications. Doesn't matter how many applications you have been hosted, but still you will have a single entry point. If you access any of these applications through URL, obviously the traffic will be redirected to the ingress controller through the name resolution. There you will have a ingress rules that controls the traffic. So based on the domain you access, traffic will be forwarded to the target services. So how we can create the ingress rules? This is a basic example how we can create the ingress rules. This is also a Kubernetes resources So just create a file with ingress kind, the name of the ingress and the specification with rules, and these are the syntax for each domains. Hyphen host along with the HTTP and the path and the backend ports where the inbound traffic should be redirected. For example, if someone is accessing sales.learnertigate.net, then it should go to the exact service what I have mentioned here. If I access purchase.learnertigate, then the traffic will be redirected to purchase-svc, not to any other service. Similarly, the last one is examples.siteone.com, and it will redirect the service to examples-svc where it is here. So this is a basic example. So the best part of this Kubernetes ingress is that it supports virtual hosting, which means you can host multiple domains in a single cluster even with different URLs. Instead of having single IP address for each domain, then you will have multiple entry point to your cluster. In this case, you can have multiple domain can point to a single target. Also, it supports both HTTP port 80 and HTTPS port 443. In order to have HTTPS 443, we should have a certificate created for the domain. Since here we have used HTTP, so this will be able to access only using HTTP port, not HTTPS. But I will show you how to create SSL certificate for each domain. We'll create a separate session for that. Also, controlling the traffic to the cluster can be easily managed through ingress rule itself. All of these rules can be done only when you have set up your Kubernetes ingress controller. Without setting up ingress controller in the Kubernetes cluster, ingress rules will not work, and there is no point of creating the ingress rules. So how to set up Kubernetes ingress controller? There are many projects that supports ingress controller. Some popular names are Engines, HAProxy, Istio, Traffic, and on public clouds we have Google Cloud, Amazon, Azure, and many more. So it's up to us to choose which controller are we going to use in our cluster. The functionality of all the ingress controllers are same. In this session, I will set up my Kubernetes ingress controller using Engines project. This is my Kubernetes cluster on AWS cloud with two worker nodes. Also, already I have some two-tier application hosted within that. The Knode is a front-end application and MongoDB is a backend. Even I have used cluster IP service, it won't be accessed from outside the cluster. At this stage, I will show you how to set up ingress controller to allow the traffic to this application from outside the cluster. And these are the default namespace being created by Kubernetes itself. If I set up Kubernetes ingress controller, we will see a dedicated namespace for the ingress controller. So all these deployment files of ingress controllers are available in GitHub. As I said before, I am using Engines. Check out the deployment files from Git repository, and this is the Git repository of Engines controller. Similarly, you will have for other projects as well. Go to the folder ingress Engines, then go to deploy, then go to static, then provider. Here you have many kind of environment. So I use AWS since my cluster is on AWS environment. Here you have two YAML files, deploy TLS terminations and deploy.yaml. So just apply this YAML. This is the complete manifest file to deploy our Kubernetes ingress controller. Kubectl apply hyphen f deploy.yaml. So it is applied. List out the namespace. See, I have a new namespace being created for ingress engines. Let's check the pods within the namespace. We have one ingress controller pod along with the supporting pods. Check out the services. Obviously, this controller should be exposed outside. So this ingress engines controller using the service type called load balancer, and we have got the external IP from ELB, and this is the external IP we have to use in our DNS to point our any domains. So it can be used to access our any applications hosted within our Kubernetes cluster from externally. Use curl command to test the URL. It is not resolving since it will take some couple of minutes on DNS for name resolution. Now it is resolving. Let's create some ingress rules for application testing. Use kubectl get ingress to list the ingress rules. Yeah, I know I have no ingress rules I've created. So I have a sample file to show you this demo, that is ingress.yaml. So make sure all your applications are using the cluster IP service type and the port that is listening to. Here the knote is the application I'll be using as a front end, and the service name is knote and the port it is listening to 80. Now open the ingress.yaml file. Let's create some rules. So these are the rule section where we have to define the host. Here I have created two host rules. One is for knote111.lanetiquette.com and the other one will be knote222.lanetiquette.com. I will make the changes accordingly. Now you have to edit your DNS for the domain name knote111.lanetiquette.com, and that should point to our ELB. Similarly, the other domain knote222.lanetiquette.com also should forward to the same ELB. If the user is accessing this domain name through URL, then the traffic will be redirected through your DNS to our ELB. From there, based on the ingress rules we have defined, we'll be redirect the traffic to the respective service name. Here we have used knote and the service port is 80. On both the host definition, we have used knote. So when you are accessing knote111 or knote222, both will be redirected to knote services. If you have a different services, for example purchase or sales, then you have to define the rules like this. Somebody is accessing purchase.lanetiquette.com, then it should redirect to the service purchase. Then sales.lanetiquette.com, that should go to sales. And also we can configure the URL pages like lanetiquette.com/purchase. If somebody accessing using these URL pages, then also that will be redirect to the exact services. And also we can configure multiple domains. Based on the host name you are giving here should be configured in DNS. Don't forget that. So let me change back to my old domain because I have configured in DNS only for knote111 and knote222. So I can show you that demo with this domain name. Also I have only the service being exposed, that is knote is the front end. So I'll be using for both domain to that service. Just save and exit from here and use kubectl apply -f and ingress.yaml. So it is created. Use kubectl get ingress to list out the ingress rules. The name we have given in the YAML file is demo ingress, and the list of hosts are been mentioned, that is knote111 and knote222. Go to your browser and enter the URL knote111. Similarly, you can try to access the second domain, that is knote222. That is also redirect the traffic to the knote service. When you have a different services for each domain, then you can use that in your ingress rules. Hope you have got an idea about Kubernetes ingress and how to set up the ingress controller. In the upcoming video, I will show you how to set up other controllers. Also, I will show you how to create our own SSL certificate for our internally hosted applications. So our application will be accessed using HTTPS for secure connection. Till then, keep practicing and have fun.
How did you feel? Is it helpful? Appreciate our efforts in the comment section below. Hit like button, share with your friends about us, subscribe our channel to get further updates. Stay connected with us on social networking sites. For more free tutorials, visit our website www.lanetiquette.net.